About to begin our day's proceedings. And to do so, we would like the host of our celebrations here of St. Peter's Parish to come forward and bring the welcome address. Please welcome Kes Gabriel Sus Nelson.
Amen. Okay, you can have a seat. Yes. In Kwandena Metachu. That is welcome in our ancient Ethiopian language. Yes, welcome to our 25th anniversary of celebrating emancipation. And the question is still being asked in this time. What is the significance of celebrating emancipation? Why we have to celebrate emancipation? And celebrating emancipation is very important to us people of African descent. Because if you remember in the Bible, after the children of Israel came out of Egypt, God commanded them to always keep the Passover. They're still keeping the Passover up to now in commemoration of their freedom. Even say, I am the God that brought you out of the house of bondage, out of the house of slavery. Yes, and we too have to remember our God who brought us out of the house of bondage, from chattel slavery, to be free in this time. We remember all that our forefathers went through, how they suffer, how they were dehumanized, And we now today, we have the freedom. So we need to celebrate and remember what our forefathers went through. So welcome again. It's been a long journey, 25 years. Not no simple thing to keep this function going, but by the help of Almighty God, and we bind it. We have no other choice but to keep it going for the next 25 years. So thanks again for coming. May God bless you. Amen.
Okay, at this time we would like to have you stand for the national anthem as it will be played by our sister Willette Tinsia, Trinidad and Tobago national anthem, which will be followed by the national anthem of Ethiopia. Please remain standing. Again, we'll just ask you for a few moments as we open with prayer. My name is Keskabre Selassie Bailey. Best me abo well the manfeskidus ahad wamlak. Amen. We give thanks unto the doer of good things, unto us the merciful God, the Father of our Lord and our God and our Savior Jesus Christ, for he had covered us and succored us. He had kept us and brought us nigh and received us unto himself, and undertaken our defense and strengthened us and brought us unto this hour. Let us therefore pray him, the Almighty Lord our God, that he keep us in this holy day and all the days of our lives in all peace. O eternal God, the first and the last one, neither beginning nor end, who art great in thy construction and mighty in thy works, wise in thy counsel and strong in thy power. Be with us, Lord, at this hour, and stand in the midst of us, and purify our hearts, and sanctify our souls, and our bodies, and our spirits. Be with us this day, dear God, during our proceedings, and take full charge of our lives. Remember, O Lord, the Honorable, Blessed, and Holy Patriarch Abba Matthias and the Blessed and Honorable Archbishop Abba Thaddeus. Remember all Orthodox bishops, priests, deacons, and Christian people. Remember our families, relatives, and friends, our neighbors. Remember also the government of Trinidad and Tobago of Ethiopia and all the governments of the world. Remember also our forefathers, those that struggled, dear God, for this emancipation celebration. Visit them in thy mercy and attend unto them in thy compassion. And strengthen us, thy people, in these challenging times, dear God, and prepare us for times to come. From all evil works, keep us apart, and in all good works, unite us. Shine upon us with the light of thy grace, for the sake of thy holy name, in which we are called, through thy only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, through whom today with him and with the Holy Spirit be glory and dominion, both now and ever, and world without end. Amen. And as you taught us to pray, our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come. Thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us and rescue us from all evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Our Lady Mary, we salute thee with the salutation of the Archangel Gabriel. Thou art virgin with thy thought and body, mother of the Almighty God. Salutation is due unto thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb. Hail, thou art highly favored, the Lord is with thee. Pray for mercy to thy beloved Son, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, to cleanse us from our sins and all unrighteousness. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, world without end. Amen. Thank you. Please be seated. At this time, we would like to continue our proceedings with a gemology from our youths of the Ethiopian Orthodox Church. They call themselves the Orthodox Drummers. Please welcome them. Okay, let's hear it for the Orthodox drummers. Without any further delay, we would like to introduce a dance by our sister Willita Haywood. Welcome. Please welcome Miss Welcome. God bless.
In my native village in Johannesburg, there is a song that we always sing when a young girl gets married. It's called the click song by the English because they cannot say onotwane. Iqhiqha lendlela ngonotwane. Iqhiqha lendlela kutwa ngonotwane. Iqhiqha
done. Please give a round of applause again to our sister. Ooh. Bless her. At this time, without any further delay, we would like to introduce our next item, a lecture by our brother Haile Mikael Wolde Amla. Please welcome Brother Wolde Amla.
Good morning, everybody. Tena yestelen. Good morning, everyone. Tena yestelen. Please permit me to sit today. Is that all right? Just wave by your hands, right? Please let me to sit. Thank you. I do have rostrum, so I would like to use the tabletop. That's all right, eh? Okay, thank you. Perhaps we can rightly say that Hayford philosophy is in essence based on the concept of Ethiopianism. The idea of Ethiopianism itself is electric, being a crystallization of religious and political notions associated with Ethiopia. Then the only truly independent island in the Sea of Colonial Africa. I repeat, then the only truly independent island in the sea of colonial Africa. Present-day Ethiopia, as we know it, was never colonialized. It remained with its independence. Ethiopia thus became a symbol of Africans' independence. Hayford identified Africa with Ethiopia. In a slave or colonial era, Ethiopia is the only African state that has not been colonialized, became a bastion of prestige or a solid foundation of pride and hope to thousands of Africans, especially those in America and in the West Indies, who were taunted by the whites for the absence of any substantial collective achievement by their race and the inability of their people to rule themselves. Gabacho, do you understand? The romanticism and the myth that shrouded this concept of Ethiopianism was no doubt engendered to bring into being by the melange of lowly spirit. Our people were of low spirit, of no motivation, of motive states of mind, frustrated hope, dreams, and resignation from escapism than real. In his Black Nationalism, has discussed fully this romantic aura of Ethiopianism in its explanation of the final beliefs of the Black nationalists. It is not surprising, therefore, to find that Ethiopianism developed in those parts of the world were likely to cause ill will or hatred, racial autonomy in the West Indies, America, South Africa, and East Africa. Ethiopia, like Jewish Zionism, is primarily a religious concept. The Jews under Moses went back to Zion after a period of slavery in Egypt. The African freed slaves thought they too would in the end go back to Africa, to Ethiopia, and displace all foreign races and so secure Africa for the Africans. The scriptures were searched, and Psalm 68, verse 31, was believed to confirm their aspirations. Ethiopia shall soon stretch out her hands unto God. This became a message of hope, and the passage was echoed and re-echoed in all Black nationalist literature. Ethiopia became a metaphysical Black heaven. This biblical passage, curiously enough, gave substance to the peculiar to make better philosophy of such a great mind as E.W. Blyden. Ethiopia's hand, in Blyden's view, are stretched out in service to God and humanity. For Africa is distinguished as having served and suffered like ancient Hebrews. His inference is that if the principle laid down by Christ is that by which things are decided above, that he who would be chief must become the servant of all, then we see the position which Africa and the Africans must ultimately occupy. This view leads him to the inevitable conclusion that both slavery and colonization were provincially designed to prepare Africans for their role of world leadership. According to the long and living Ethiopian tradition, there are seven covenants as enshrined in the scriptures that God made with humanity ever since creation. The first of these covenants is signified and eternalized by the matrimony of Adam and Eve. The second, by the rainbow of Noah. The third, by the bread and wine offering of Melchizedek. The fourth, by the circumcision of Abraham. The fifth, by the ark of Moses. The sixth, by the throne of David. The seventh and the last, by the crucified body and blood of Jesus Christ, born of the Virgin Mary. The covenants, as described above, each symbolize real signs and are personified by humble individuals who please God with their love for Him. These persons became unique and parties of their respective covenants with God, following their singular triumph over great trials of various physical and spiritual dimensions. And these trials were meant to test the truthfulness of their love for God before each one of them actually won His favor to be chosen as a representative party for the specific divine covenant. Continuing, these seven covenants constitute Ethiopia or the Ethiopians. In other words, Ethiopia or the Ethiopians is these seven covenants, and these seven covenants are Ethiopia or the Ethiopians. Devoid of them or outside the context and realm of these seven covenants, there is no Ethiopia and no Ethiopian. Hence, the biblical or the Old and New Testimonial truth endorses and identifies Ethiopia conclusively as the true Israel. And the Ethiopians are the true Israelites, as spelled out below in greater detail. And I quote an address by our former patriot, Abuna Palos, at the Synod Vatican City, October 7, 2009. He says, "The history of the Ethiopian Enoch and the strong, well-organized law of Moses and the religious practices and culture in depth that exists in Ethiopia indicates that the law of Moses used to be practiced in Ethiopia better than that of in Israel. Still, this can be witnessed by studying culture and living styles of the Ethiopians." End quote. The existence of Ethiopia and the life of the Ethiopians are both based on and intertwined by these seven covenants. Not only do the religious, the cultural, and the social fabric of the Ethiopian lives, but also their educational, economic, and political principles emanate from these covenants. This is Ethiopianism. Quote, Prophet Jeremiah chapter 13 verse 23, "Can the Ethiopian change his skin or the leopard his spots?" From the book of Orthodoxy's Orthodoxy by deceased Abba Hachman Dry Hadis Gesesi, page 9, he says, "Halifa is North Ethiopia, the modern name Eritrea. The river went out from Eden in Amharic, the Ethiopian language, Eden means Genet, another word for heaven, to water the garden where God Amlak created Adam and Eve. That is the holy land which is called Ethiopia, which means black, to identify the peculiar and distinct complexion of the Ethiopians. Gion is the ancient name for the river Nile, the holy water, the mother or source of Jordan. For the Ethiopians, the river Nile is from the beginning and the water of life. The Ethiopians, or Cushites, or Hamites, they are chosen people and the children of God, Amlak. And I am speaking of the Ethiopians inside and outside of Ethiopia." Ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters, I want to thank you for your keen listening ear. Thank you very much.
Yes, let's hear it from Brother Haile Michael Wolde Amlak. I know much knowledge has been shared here this morning, and we are about to close this first segment of our session of emancipation. As you all are aware, this goes until 6 this afternoon, and we are asking each to support the various stalls that we have around us, okay? And we ask that we as a people, you know, be conscious in whatsoever we do and in whatsoever we say. At this time, we would like to have the blessing of the various stalls. Sir DJ, thank you.
San Fernando, get ready for a musical and dance treat. We are about to have a musical and dance number by our own brethren and sister of the Ethiopian Orthodox Church. Wolete Hayward is about to give us a performance for our afternoon's celebrations of emancipation, our 25th anniversary. For all who'd like to gather, just take a look up here at the bandstand as we're about to start.
Greetings in the name of Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, one God. Amen. What taking place here today is all about emancipation. We, the members of the Ethiopian Orthodox Church in St. Peter's Parish, San Fernando, we've been celebrating emancipation for 25 years now. So this is like our silver jubilee, and we are thankful to God for giving us the opportunity to celebrate another year. As you know, the question is always being asked, why we celebrate emancipation, what is the significance of emancipation? But emancipation for us is of much significance. If we, when we read the Bible, when the children of Israel were set free from captivity under Pharaoh, God tell them always to keep the Passover. In fact, up to today, the children of Israel still keep the Passover. The Passover was like, Passover is like us. Like emancipation, a celebration, celebrating the freedom from under Pharaoh. I even tell them that I am the Lord thy God that brought us out, brought you out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of bondage. So we too have to remember Almighty God who set our forefathers free from slavery. Because shattered slavery is not a simple matter. It's they dehumanize our people, make them worse than animal. And to be free from that is a reason to rejoice and to be happy and to celebrate. And to remember our ancestors, what they go through, and to try and elevate ourselves as African people. Try to reflect on what's going on with our people. We see the situation with our youths and crime. It's because of lack of culture and lack of tradition. They don't know themselves. It's self-hate. In 1970, we teach them black is beautiful, but for somehow that spirit of 1970 didn't take root. So today, our youths, they have hate for self-hate, and so they're killing one another. But we still have hope in Almighty God that they will see the light. That is why we too, as the Ethiopian Orthodox Church, come out here to show them that they have culture, they have history, they have tradition, they have something that belong to them then. Because Ethiopia is a true emancipator. Ethiopia was never conquered by the European. Twice they tried to conquer Ethiopia, but they were defeated in the Battle of Adowa. When Italy come up against Ethiopia, at that time King Menelik, he defeated the Italians, and then again in His Majesty Emperor Haile Selassie time, they came again 40 years after, and they were defeated again. So the people in the West look to Ethiopia because we never thought then our black nation could stand up against the Europeans, because the way how they was dominating the Africans. So Ethiopia is a light unto the rest of the world, and especially African people in the diaspora. Ethiopia have history. From the Bible, the Garden of Eden, the first nation, one of the rivers compassed the whole land of Ethiopia. And then the Queen of Sheba went and visited King Solomon and brought Judaism. And then the Ethiopian eunuch went to Jerusalem to worship. And then the Spirit tell Philip to go and baptize him. And so Christianity was brought to Ethiopia in 34 AD. So we have history, we have culture, and that is where we come to show the people. And that is why every year we celebrate. This year, as we say, 25 years, we have 3 days of celebration. Today, we are on the promenade here. And then tomorrow again, we're here with a treat for the children and a talent show. Children with talent will come and express themselves because they have the talent, but they never get a chance to perform in front of audience. Here they will be getting the chance, and yet still they will get to know about emancipation, because now school is holiday time, school closed, and they don't be, nothing is being said about emancipation to the children. They don't know about emancipation, so we giving them the opportunity to learn about emancipation. Then tomorrow, Sunday, we'll be having a Thanksgiving service at our church in Dallas Avenue, Cookie Village, officiated by His Grace Abuna Thaddeus. And then that is 8 a.m. in the morning. And then from 10 a.m. we'll have a street procession from Dallas Avenue to Palms Club San Fernando, where we'll have lunch and then a cultural program in the evening. Okay, so thank you. All the best to you. God bless.